Well, no further rate cuts, at least for the time being. Federal Reserve Chairman Jerome Powell said last night that interest rates look, quote, well positioned where they are right now. In a speech in Providence, Powell said he also sees the glass as, quote, much more than half full, end quote, but pointed to the usual suspects in justifying the three rate cuts this year. That's citing tepid inflationary pressures, weakening global growth, and also trade developments. Now, for what it's worth, markets are currently pricing in a 93.4% chance, the purple bar on the screen ahead of you, of no change in the Fed's last meeting of 2019, with a small sliver, that little blue bar there, of a chance of maybe a rate hike. Probably not going to happen. But anyway, guys, what did you glean from the Powell speech yesterday? Important to note that we're a few weeks away still from the next Fed meeting. That's on December 11.
He's giving himself a big pat on the back, saying, you know what, interest rates are where they need to be right now, well positioned, because he put them there. And he's saying that it's not going to affect the U.S. economy's expansion. So when in our 11th year, the unemployment rate is at 3.5%. And he's basically putting the ball in the court of Washington. If there actually were to be a recession, we would need fiscal stimulus, and that would be out of his hands.
Well, and Sibile, to your point, I agree. I don't think he deserves that pat on the back. I mean, you know, rewind 12 months ago, 13 months ago, he said we are far away from the neutral rate of interest rates. Almost the complete opposite of what he just said last night. So you have to wonder, where was his head a year ago, and what has changed a year later?
Yeah, and a lot of people within the Federal Reserve kind of acknowledging that that last December rate hike that we saw in 2018 last year may have been a mistake. We haven't heard the Fed chair really kind of full-throatedly say that was the case, but you have to argue to what degree maybe the Fed tightened a little bit too much. But the question now that's prevailing is really, are three rate cuts enough to offset that?
Well, and right. It's hard to reverse four rate hikes. I mean, the lag time when you hike interest rates to how it feels in the economy is, you know, what, 6-7 months? So when you talk about four rate hikes, that could be felt for years to come. Now, it's interesting to see the market clearly reacts much faster. You look at the 10-year yield. Obviously, the Fed has cut interest rates over the past couple of months, but the 10-year yield has actually risen, which is pretty remarkable if you look at the 10-year yield over the past 2 months.
And what I'm always paying attention to is, of course, what's happening with President Trump. So we saw the visuals recently. He met with President Trump at the White House. We don't know the details of their discussion.
We won't for a while.
Right. But do you think President Trump is going to lay off him a little bit, or he's still going to ask for those negative interest rates, which we know is not good for the U.S. economy?
President Trump has actually, in all fairness, eased up a little bit on the Federal Reserve as of the last few months. I think a lot of that is because the Federal Reserve did cut interest rates like he wanted him to. But the other part of it is, I think he's worried more about the impeachment right now than about what Jay Powell is doing.
Yeah, he's got bigger fish to fry.
Exactly. So for the time being, it seems like maybe the criticism has let up for the time being. But guys, I'm wondering, in terms of that next meeting, right? It seems like it's a done deal that there won't be any changes. But what about 2020? We're going to get a new dot plot projection. What's kind of like the quick takeaway for what we're seeing headed into next year?
I think the pressure is going to stay on Fed Chair Powell. I don't think he's going to get away with it. I think in December he can keep rates steady, but next year the pressure is going to be back on to cut more interest rates, especially if the economy goes south.
I don't think the market is thinking about 2020 right now. I think normally it would be this time of year, but you have so many other factors that need to kind of materialize before the end of the year, and I think the December meeting is going to be a lame duck meeting.
All right, well, we'll see.
Hey, investors, Zach Guzman here. Are you interested in learning more about the markets and getting the latest financial news? Well, then click right here to subscribe to our Yahoo Finance YouTube channel. Get the latest up-to-the-minute market analysis, big interviews in the world of finance, and information on how to manage your money every day, wherever you are.